committee. Over to you, Honorable Sikala.
Thank you very much, Chairman, our Chairman of the Youth Assembly, Comrade of Estole. I'm also realizing that some of our leaders are here to come and follow this press conference. I also would like to thank you, members of the 40th State, to come and share with us the resolutions of the National Strategic Committee that was done yesterday. Basically, I think before going into the statement, there shouldn't be any panic, as I have witnessed since yesterday over this press conference. I did not come here to declare war or a revolution. I come here to share with you the resolutions of our National Standing Committee, which sat yesterday for over 5 hours and made very crucial deliberations on a wide range of issues that are currently affecting our country. So I'm going to share with you what we resolved as the leadership of the Movement for Democratic Change Alliance under the leadership of Advocate Nelson Chamisa. And also let me emphasize this. We are united in every aspect that we do. The people's cause and the revolution is in safe hands. People must not panic. Everything is under control. So realizing that the lockdown has been abused to lock down only the people in the MDCA Alliance to ambush the people with Supreme Court judgment and recalling of the people's members of parliament, acknowledging the desperate attempts by the regime to destabilize, weaken and destroy the People's Party, the MDCA Alliance, a voluntary association, by seeking to impose and force it to accept puppet leaders imposed upon it by the system, rejecting the illegal act in parliament to illegally and unlawfully recall MDCA Alliance MPs at the instruction of imposters purporting to represent that party, further rejecting the Speaker of Parliament, the abuse of Parliament to fight MDCA Alliance for insisting on Emmerson Mnangagwa's illegitimacy. This act has taken illegitimacy to Parliament. Only an illegitimate president will preside over this kind of a circus. State institutions are being abused to destroy the opposition, using and abusing the instruments of the state. Nobody who works with the regime against the people will ever succeed. The will of the people will ever triumph. Convinced that what is being witnessed is a war by Mnangagwa and ZANU-PF through proxies against the MDCA Alliance, having not forgiven the party for defeating him in the 2018 general elections, the end game is to totally annihilate the opposition and establish a one-party state. Concerned that the biggest crime that the MDCA Alliance and its candidate committed was to garner over 2 million votes in the last presidential elections, which is a serious threat to the system and the reason for this frantic effort to destroy or eliminate the MDCA Alliance. They want the MDCA Alliance to join Poland. They want the MDCA Alliance President Advocate Nelson Chamisa to accept to be the leader of the opposition in parliament. They wanted MDCA Alliance to accept the stolen election outcome. They wanted the MDCA Alliance MPs to recognize Emmerson Mnangagwa as a legitimate president of Zimbabwe after the stolen and disputed elections of 2018. They want to tell the MDC Alliance to partner and not to oppose the tyrannical and authoritarian regime of Emmerson Mnangagwa. Therefore, in this context, the National Standing Committee of the MDC Alliance met yesterday in Harare and made the following resolutions. One, The standing committee noted the perverse and insidious attempt by the ZANU-PF and its proxies to dismember the MDC alliance by executing a coup against the legitimately elected leadership of the MDC alliance under the guise of implementing the equally insidious judgment of the Supreme Court, which seeks to foist ZANU-PF proxies as leaders of the MDC alliance in brazen violation of the MDC constitution. The standing committee thus resolved to reject in toto and with utter contempt the ZANU-PF and this proxy's attempt to force its cousins and partners as leaders of the MDC alliance. All MDC alliance MPs will forthwith suspend all participation in parliament and disengage from all platforms in which the party has to interact with ZANU-PF, pending consultations with the relevant constituencies of the party, that is the electorate and Zimbabweans at large, on the decision for a total withdrawal from parliament. The party reiterates that only the MDC alliance has the power to lawfully recall or redeploy its members of parliament elected under its ticket. No one else has the mandate to do so, except only the MDC alliance. The MDC alliance, in the meantime, is engaging the National Executive Council and the National Council of the party and all other organs and the people of Zimbabwe in general on a robust program of action to resolve the legitimacy national question which Zimbabwe has been confronted with since Emmerson Mnangagwa installed himself to be the president of this country. The MDC alliance will roll out a program of action together with civil society, professional bodies, churches, labor, business, war veterans, political parties, women and youth groups. The MDC alliance will not accept the holding of a ZANU-PF organized extraordinary congress in the MDC. ZANU-PF cannot write another political party's constitution and hold a congress on its behalf to impose a puppet leadership that would be malleable to Emmerson Mnangagwa as the principal leader of that political party. The MDC alliance has noted that Morgan Komichi, Douglas Mwonzora, and Elias Mudzuri have decided to cooperate with ZANU-PF and the state. They therefore have expelled themselves from the MDC alliance and are forthwith relieved of their positions and membership in the party. They are further withdrawn from all positions to which they had been deployed by the party. Replacements have been met and shall be announced in due course. The party resolved to take all the necessary steps to recover all the gains of the people's democratic struggle. The Supreme Court judgment has engendered an illegality by seeking to extend the expired mandate of the 2014 structures, which had since expired. The term of office of all 2014 structures expired in October 2019, and the toxic judgment illegal seeks to give a Lazarus moment by seeking to resurrect the expired mandate of the 2014 MDCT structures. The National Standing Committee took note of the COVID-19 pandemic and the dislocated livelihoods of the vulnerable and the majority of Zimbabweans who are surviving in the informal sector. The illegitimate regime of Emmerson Mnangagwa has provided no safety nets whatsoever to assist the despondent Zimbabweans. They have instead deployed the vending stalls where the majority of Zimbabweans are making a living through informal trading. Pursuant to our Agenda 2020 program of action, we forward the five fights that we, the people of Zimbabwe, must pursue this year without fail as follows: the fight for the people's government, reforms and the return to legitimacy, the fight for a better life, dignity and livelihood, the fight against corruption, the fight for rights freedoms, security of persons, and rule of law. They fight in defense of the Constitution and the constitutional and constitutionalism. We now call upon the people of Zimbabwe to build a broad consensus and united front for all progressive citizens to agree to address the national crisis. So I thank you. God bless you, members of the Fourth Estate.